Today we are in Amsterdam, and we are going to show you a truly remarkable building. Let's meet Joke, who is a program developer circularity at the AMS Institute. Hi Joke.
Hi Arjen, great to be here.
This building really looks interesting to me. Although you wouldn't say, it's entirely made out of timber, right?
It is, indeed. And timber manufacturing actually has gone a really long way the past few years. So much so that tall buildings such as this one can be constructed almost entirely out of timber.
Wow, it intrigues me. Let's have a look.
Let's.
It's a beautiful space, really. You know, it's a misconception that with timber you cannot make grand modern architecture, but this atrium is really convincing. It's showing that you can, actually.
It's incredible indeed. What's good to know is that we're currently in Hotel Jakarta, referring to the capital of Indonesia, and that's because historically this hotel is built along the docks where the ships to Jakarta used to leave. And we can see that translated into the bamboo finishings, this tropical garden, and the big beams spanning the atrium. I feel like we're really experiencing a celebration to the namesake of the hotel in this place.
Yes, it is. It is. It's so convincing.
Absolutely. Shall we go take a closer look upstairs?
Great idea. Let's do that.
And these bamboo finishings, they have a beautiful tactile quality to them as well.
They do, really. It's so soft, really nice. Mm. But you know, there's so much more to bamboo and to timber in general than just the aesthetics. Imagine that 35% of all global greenhouse gas emissions are related to the other materials, to the unorganic or the non-renewable materials like concrete, like cement, plastics, metals. And this is really what you can substitute by using timber. Using timber will result in healthier buildings, which store carbon instead of emitting it, while the raw resource, the trees, grows back and absorbs even more carbon from the atmosphere. And there's something more. There's so much more to this than just climate-related aspects. I mean, this is also related to health and to resource scarcity. And look at this roof. There's really integrated PV cells in the glass ceiling, and it is BREEAM excellent. So it's really an integrated concept.
Right. Timber construction is crucial in reducing global greenhouse gas emissions and by extension achieving the Sustainable Development Goals, honoring the Paris Agreement. But we have to be mindful though, we can't just use any kind of timber. It needs to be the right timber. And the right timber, what I mean with that, is that it needs to be sustainably sourced. There is indeed enough availability of that type of sustainably sourced softwood in the world. But really what I want to stress here is the importance of timber construction going hand in hand with sustainable forestry.
Yeah, I think sustainable forest management allows us to grow our forests and to make our planet more green, and at the same time to capture carbon, so make it carbon positive, while at the same time having sufficient resources for buildings like this.
Absolutely, and that is why we can get massive carbon gains. Did you know that replacing just 1 ton of concrete and steel with 1 ton of sustainably sourced softwood, we can save up as much as 1.5 tons of carbon emissions? Imagine that on the scale of a building, a neighborhood, or even an entire city. By the way, Arjen, next to these environmental considerations, I'd like to show you one more thing, if that's okay. Should we go have a look?
I'm curious what you're going to show. Let me. Wow, look at this.
We are now in one of the 200 hotel rooms of Hotel Jakarta, and every single one of these hotel rooms have been prefabricated. And what this has done to the construction process is actually it's sped it up incredibly. Constructing all of these 200 rooms here on site only took 2 weeks.
2 weeks, incredible. I mean, look at that. Actually, the speeding up, let's say the construction time of a building like this, in this case the Hotel Jakarta, it really helps make timber a feasible alternative for abiotic, for conventional building materials. Mm-hmm. And actually it even introduces higher quality standards like we see here. Look at the light, look at the finishing, the quality, the height quality, but also the silence. It makes me a bit zen. I mean, the room is really beautiful.
It's stunning.
Yeah.
And what's more, with these prefabrication methods of manufacturing, of constructing, it actually allows us to introduce circular building practices, meaning that we can start reusing bits and pieces of the building after our needs start changing or when our needs start changing. This can happen on the product level, the component level, or even the entire building level.
Wow. So this is a beautiful room with a beautiful view. Let's see.
Absolutely. Let's have a look. Well, Arjen, I think I'm convinced. I think we've seen the future of a post-carbon construction world.
Yes, I think so too. But not just the future, actually, it's the present. Because here we are. We have been seeing this building, which has been built in such a speedy time. This is the present, and this is something which will help change our world.
Absolutely.
And what a view, right?